ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
Sixth canto, second chapter, verse number 7.
Ayam hi krita nirvesho janma koti anghasam api yad vyajahara divasho nama Swasti ayanam hare ayam hi krita nirvesho ayam hi krita nirvesho janma kotyang hasamapi janma kotyang hasamapi Yad vyajahara vivasho. Yad vyajahara vivasho. Nama swastyayanam hare. Ayam hi krita nirvesho. Janma kotyang hasamapi. Yad vyajahara vivasho. Nama swastyayanam hare.
Ayam hi krita nirvesho janma kotyang hasamapi. Yad vyajahara vivasho. Nama swastyayanam hare. So, the order carriers of Lord Vishnu, Vishnu Duta, declare that this man, although he was very sinful, but now he is cleared of all sinful acts. He is now clean. How he is clean? Jad bhajahara. He has uttered the name of Narayan. Jad bhajahara. Vibhasa. Not any artificial, but automatically. Vibhasa. Nama, the holy name. Sasti ayanam. To chant the holy name of the Lord means to achieve all auspicity. Hare. Now this name, Hare, sometimes the Mayavadis, they say that any name, either of Hari or any other demigod is equal. No, that is not. That is Namapura. If one thinks that the holy name of Hari is as good as the name of other demigod, then it is Namapura. That is not Shuddhana. So, people are being misguided in that way. But the Shastra does not say that. The Shastra says, Harir Nama. Harir Nama. The holy name of Hari, Krishna, Vishnu, Vishnu Tattva. Hari means Vishnu Tattva. There are Tattva is manifested in different ways. Vishnu Tattva, Vishnu Shakti Tattva, Jiva Tattva, like that. So, Shastra says, Harir Nama, Vishnu Tattva. Vishnu, of course, Lord Vishnu has several thousands of names according to his different activities. Vishnu, Narayan, Hari, Govinda, Madhava, many names. So, any name of the Supreme Personality of God, Hari. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. The Shastra reminding us three times. Just like we stress upon something that do this, do this, do this, thrice. Therefore it is said three times, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, so that you may not forget, you may not be misguided by the so-called Mayavadis, that any name, no, Hare Rama, three times. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, eva, again eva. Then again three times, kalo nasti eva, nasti eva, nasti, nasti eva, gatiranatha. You cannot deviate from this process. There is no other alternative process. You cannot say that I will be liberated by this process or that process. No. Because it is Kali Yuga, any other process will not be successful. You adopt any process, ultimately you have to come to this process, Bhakti Yoga. You can work on Karma Yoga, you can work on Jnana Yoga, you can work on Hatha Yoga. There are different yogas. Yoga means how to connect with the Supreme. Yoga means connection. And Vyoga means distraction. We know, anyone who knows mathematics, yoga. Yoga means addition and subtraction. Vyoga. So, at the present moment, in our condition and state, we are separated. Not exactly separated, but we are forgotten. We have forgotten our relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, we have to connect it again. That is called yoga. Because we are now disconnected somehow or other, now we have to connect it again. So any yoga system means an endeavor to connect our relationship with the Supreme Lord. That is called yoga. So someone is trying to make the connection Karma Yoga, someone is trying by Jnana Yoga, someone is trying Hatha Yoga. But the real aim is Bhakti Yoga. Just like different steps. You are on the first step, and other is on the second step, and other is on the third step, and other is on the fourth step. But the ultimate goal is Bhakti Yoga. You cannot understand God or Krishna by any other yoga. It may be a step forward. But ultimately, you have to come to the Bhakti Yoga. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Bahunam Janmanam Ante. After many, many births, endeavor to execute the yoga system, Bahunam Janmanam Ante. Jnanavan, one who is actually practicing Jnana Yoga or mystic yoga, he comes to the Bhakti Yoga. Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavan Mang Prapadyate. Prapadyate. This is Bhakti Yoga. And still clearly explained. What is that prapatti? Vasudeva Sarvamiti Samahatma Sudullava. When one comes to this understanding that Vasudeva Krishna is everything, I surrender to Krishna. Krishna is canvassing personally. Krishna is so kind that sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam. That we will not take. Krishna is claiming too much. But that is the ultimate goal, that you have to surrender to Krishna. That is the highest perfection. So this conclusion that let me surrender, Krishna is asking me, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the ultimate absolute truth, He is asking me to surrender, why should I delay? Let me surrender. This is intelligence, jnana. So those who are intelligent, they will take immediately. It is explained in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Saddha Shabde Vishas Sudhira Nishchay Krishne Bhakti Kaile Sarva Karma Krita Hoy. This is the real Saddha, faith. What is that faith? Saddha Shabde Vishas. Faith means strong faith, not flickering faith. Vishas, to believe. What is that? Vishas, Saddha Shabde Vishas, Sudhira Nishchay. Very firm faith and with surety. Surety it must be. Because Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, says that you surrender unto me and I shall give you protection from all sinful years. He is assuring. Then why we shall doubt? Because we have doubt in Krishna. That is the difference. The Krishna says he is maybe or may not doubt. That is called doubt. Krishna says in many places, asamsaya, don't doubt what I say, accept it. Manmana bhava madbhakta madhyadi mangana mukskuru mameva ishasi asamsaya. You do this, and without any doubt, rest assured, you will come to me. In another place, Krishna says, Mayasakta mana pratha yogam junyana madasi asamsayam. Again asamsayam. Asamsayam samagram maam yatha gyasasi tachinu. So it is our misfortune that we become doubtful about Krishna. This is our misfortune. Otherwise, to become liberated, to go back to home, back to Godhead, very easy thing, provided we accept the Krishna's version as it is, without any change. It is very easy. Krishna, when He comes personally, He comes to bestow the mercy to the fallen souls. And He speaks very clearly that matta parataram nanyat kinchi jasti dhananjaya. There is no more better, positive truth than myself. But you don't believe. That is the misfortune. But this man, although he did not know what he is doing, but very faithfully he chanted vibhasa, without any hesitation. Vibhasa means being forced. He was forced to chant. So jena tena prakarena, if you chant without any committing any offense the holy name of the Lord, then you become liberated. This is the purpose of this Ajami Upakhyan. Ayam hi krita nidvesha. Nidvesha means atonement. If you commit some sin, then you should atone for it. Otherwise, you have to carry the reaction of your sinful life to the next life. Therefore, according to the Vedic system, there is prayaschitta. The prayaschitta, that is also a very heavy task. In this age, nobody can perform prayaschitta. And even one is able to perform prayaschitta, then there is possibility of again falling down, unless one is clear consciousness, and that Krishna consciousness. Unless one is Krishna conscious, there is every chance of falling down. So anyway, this ajamin is kritanirbhisha. Vishnu Duta informed to the Jamaduta that you cannot touch him anymore. He is now pure. Kritanirbhisha. Kritanirbhisha. Then the next question is, the Jamaduta may say that how he has become kritanirbhisha. He is so sinful that there is no limit of his sinful activities, and you say that it is clear immediately. Therefore he says, janma koti anghasamapi. Not only one life sinful activities, but many crores of birth sinful activities. So we do not know how many births we had previously. But from the Shastra we understand crores, many millions of times we had to take birth. That word is used, janma koti. Not one birth, or two births, or second birth, or third birth. So, unless we come to Krishna consciousness, this repetition of birth and death will continue. That's what he said, janma kotyam. We are passing through many forms of, different forms of life. We are creating one family, that I belong to this family. But what about my other families? Because janma koti, in every family when I enter, there must be father and mother and family members. To which family I am especially concerned? That is our ignorance. We become interested in the particular family where we are at present. But we do not know that in the past we have to pass through many hundreds and millions of families. So which family is correct? And again, if I do not correct myself at the present moment, I have to go through many millions of families until we come to the point, Vasudeva Sarvamiti Samahatma. This is it. So, this Vasudeva Sarvamiti we are distributing on the order of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. People may take that Krishna consciousness movement means that we are preaching Vasudeva Sarvamiti, no compromise. Only Vasudeva, Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavati Vasudeva. This is Krishna consciousness movement. If people can take it without any hesitation, as Krishna says, Ma Sucha, don't be worried. Sarvadharman Paritajya Mamekam Saranam Braja. Krishna says, even out of sentiment, we take to Krishna consciousness, believing on the word of Krishna. Out of sentiment, still we are believing. Taktya sadhanmam charanam bhujam hare. It is said that if by sentiment one takes to Krishna consciousness, tattva sadharmam, everyone has got his occupational duty. The Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, or everyone has got some particular duty, obligation. But Krishna says there is no need of executing all these obligations. Simply surrender. Krishna says. So, if somebody out of sentiment, if one thinks that simply by surrendering to Krishna he will be perfect, why not take it? Let me give up my so-called religious principle. That is called form in the Bhagavad. Taktya sadharmam charanambujam hare. He giving up. Just like this European American boy, they belong to Jewish religion, they belong to Christian religion, but out of their pious activities or even by sentiment, they have given up. Now they have taken to Krishna consciousness. But they are perfect. You may say that some of them have fallen. The Shastra says that even one has fallen, where is the wrong there? And other person who has not taken to Krishna consciousness, who has not fallen, what is the benefit there? Even one has not fallen, sticking to his own particular religious system, he is not gainer. But a person who has taken to Krishna consciousness even by sentiment and has fallen, he has great benefit. Because once he has taken to Krishna consciousness, Krishna becomes attached to him. That is Agnata Sukriti. Therefore, in all circumstances, we should accept the Krishna's instruction, sarva-dharmān paritajya-māmetaṁ-saranam-vajā. And surely we shall be benefited. So it doesn't matter whether he is advanced. Of course, everyone should try his best to advance more and more in Krishna consciousness. But even though one falls down circumstantially, tattva sadharmam charanam bhujam hari pate tato jadi bhajan apakya. Bhajan means this execution of devotional service. Gradually it should be strong and right. But if one falls down, even it is not right. Bhajan apakkata. So Shastra says, what is wrong there? What is the loss there? Because he has begun this line of devotional service. Even if he stopped at a certain point, circumstantially, he is not loser because he will get the opportunity of another human form of life. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Suchinam simatangehe yogam prashta sanjayate. Even one has fallen down, still he will get the chance of taking birth. Suchinam simatangehe. In the family of Brahmana, first class Brahmana, Suchi, very pure, or Srivata, or very rich man, rich Vaishya. Generally the Vaishyas are rich. So he will get chance either in a very good family of Brahmin or Vaishya. Vaishyas are generally devotees. Therefore, he gets the chance of taking birth in a nice family. And if he is fortunate, or if he is guided, then he begins again Krishna consciousness from the point where he lost. Therefore, he is not loser. Whereas others who are not in Krishna consciousness, he may be diverted, and there is no guarantee what is the next path. Krishna does not guarantee. Krishna says, takta deham punarjanma. Krishna says, dehi nasmin yatha dehi kaumar jovana jara tatha dehantara prapti. Dehantara prapti, he will get another body. But what kind of body he is going to get, that is not certain. He may be a demigod or he may be a dog, according to his karma. But this man, who is a devotee of Krishna, if he is fallen and if he has to take birth again, it is guaranteed. Sujinang asimatangi, he will take birth in a very rich family or in a very pure family. This is guaranteed. For others, there is no guarantee. He may take birth out of the 8,400,000 of different forms of life. There is no guarantee. So our request is that somehow or other take to Krishna consciousness. Even if you fall down without being ripe, still you are not loser. That is our request. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.